was important for me to find that final, that great image where I feel like this is the end of the world. And it came back to me that when I was a kid, we had these anthills behind our house. And so I have to put that image one day into a movie. And then I suddenly said, this could be amazing if I have this, like, this hill of zombies coming at me and how they climb on top of each other and how this tsunami of zombies coming towards me. And I felt that that image is powerful enough to feel like this is the end of the world.
We've lost the East Coast. Moscow's still dark. Life as we know it will come to an end in 90 days.
World War Z sees Brad Pitt doing his best impression of an everyman by playing a UN investigator sent around the world to piece together exactly where the zombie apocalypse began. And aside from a few cliches and a god-awful voiceover, it's actually a fairly scary thriller with a mixture of both huge action set pieces and the far better, smaller, claustrophobic scares.
Get back in your car right now! Remain with your
That said, though, it is based on a much-loved book from which it bears pretty much no resemblance.
What are we doing?
It's our way out of here.
Why then keep the title? Because it's kind of, it creates its own world. Why take the title of World War Z?
I believe, you know, it's a companion piece to the book, and at the same time, I still try to capture the spirit of the book, even though it's different, because the book is not a template for a linear narrative movie. It's sort of like 54 stories from different accounts how people survived the apocalypse. The movie is sort of a linear narrative three-act story. So I felt like this is the right way to, you know, go.
Think we're gonna find anything?
Yeah, we're gonna find something.
Every filmmaker who creates a zombie movie gets to reinvent the undead for themselves. From the original shuffling variety of zombie created by George Romero back in The Night of the Living Dead.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
Through to running rabies zombies in 28 Days Later.
I can see them, they're coming!
Through to stripping zombies in the remarkably aptly titled Zombie Strippers.
I could just eat you alive.
So was Marc concerned about what would make a distinctive Forster zombie?
I had like a lot of references I looked into and had a whole like Z boot camp for months and months and months.
What
and
do you do in Z boot camp?
It's just like to create like how they move and how different they move. And that's sort of the ideology, and you almost create your own philosophy for them.
Mother Nature is a serial killer. No one's better.
George Romero zombies were always metaphors for something. Mm. In World War Z, what are the zombies a metaphor for?
They're definitely a metaphor here as well. I mean, I think, you know, those kind of end of the world kind of movies are always popular in a time of change. In the 70s, you know, it was a time of change. Today is a time of change. A lot of people, you know, have a certain fear about the future economically and environmentally. So that's why I wanted to create the film to set it mostly in really reality, that you feel this is completely real. And because of that, you're like at the edge of your seat throughout the entire movie.
Can't leave my family. Take a look around here, Mr. Wayne. You want to help your family? Let's figure out how we stop this.
Famously, the ending of the movie was changed. I'm curious, what was the original ending and how did it change?
The original ending was basically a huge battle. And it's like in a lot of the Hollywood blockbusters these days, the last set piece needs to be bigger than everything else. And we shot and I felt like, said to Stu, let's not finish this with all the CG, we're going to spend all the money. Let's do an ending which is very quiet. Let's go opposite like everybody else, because I feel like at the end, you know, you want to be just with Brad and the zombie, and it has to be reflective and intimate, and I felt that would be a better way to go.
Child there, thank you.